Hello again. I'm Shima for those of you who...
I hope this is your last talk you're
getting. Yeah. Yeah, I was discussing with Raka next year, I don't have to do any. So, yesterday I was talking about... And today I'm going to talk about a project that I live off, basically. So, our customer is a Slovenian national television, and it has a website that has about 1 million daily users. Slovenia is a 2 million people country, so it's basically, you get the picture. Our part of the website is Audio Video Archive. It has 1,700,000 clips, basically in different formats. They are done daily, and the import is really huge. And our API on the archive only has 3,000 concurrent requests, so it's pretty big low. So before this archive, there was an old structure that was based on Oracle and Java. It was pretty, really, really slow. It was unmaintained and unflexible because it was basically a black box. Nobody knew what it actually did. So even the guy who used to maintain it, he quit his job and never heard from him again. So we were handling the streaming part and the live and VOD streaming part. So we were discussing with the client to take over also the archive itself, the data. And in comes the answer. This was done in 2000. This was around 2012. So we did a little, some smaller projects on Dancer, so we decided to use it also on this one. And we also decided to use Template Flute, basically because Rocket is Rocket's creation.
We have access to Rocket.
And we have access to Rocket, so. And we knew that further on we would need a complex set of rules for different users, because in the beginning it was used only by operators, and after now it's spreading throughout the whole national television in different parts of it. So we just started without extensible. And since we weren't sure how it's gonna work, we decided to do a small part of it first. It's basically a control for a live streaming system. The system is the content has to be geo-blocked if there are no rights for streaming it, either in Slovenia or anywhere. So we have to tell to the streaming system to block it. So we basically connected it to the schedule, and it communicates. It looks like something like this. Actually, it still looks exactly like this. And it has a force option also. So if the schedule is not available or for some reason it's not updated, they can force it. And then the next thing was the archive, so the big thing. So first we migrated Oracle to MySQL. And we still have problems with that legacy databases. And then connected with Dancer. We use Dancer plugin database mostly because I lacked other skills at that time. So, and this was really easy to use. So now I'm kind of regretting that I didn't take more time to use to learn DBX Plus at that time, but I'm trying to set it up so I could migrate eventually. This is the editing section of the archive where they can like import and put different metadata inside. Archive comes from right now 8 different sources. Some come with an XML, some come with a convention naming, so we at least have some data, and a lot of them come without any data. Some come as different, also as a unsupported format. So we did also the transcoder, where basically it transcodes and transcodes the files in into acceptable ones, and then imports them into the archive. So the next thing was to make an API. It's also done on JSON. The problem with the API, we needed full text search, basically. This is how the front end looks. This wasn't done by us, but it uses our API. It has an autocomplete and a full text search, so it was pretty heavy load for the API. And we then introduced Solr into it. We used web service Solr because it was the only one available at that time. Now, at the first, there was only the archive index. Now there are 2 of them. There is also a level above it. It's called shows, so they can do also full text search on it. With introducing 2 indexes, we had some performance issues because basically we have a Solr slave and a MySQL slave, and it updates on the there is an API and editing, and the slave is on the API. So with the updating of the 2 Solr indexes, this because the Solr was under such a heavy load, it crashed. So, but it was pretty simply solved by lowering the frequency, update frequency. By lowering the update frequency, it now it can handle it normally as it did. You asked me why not use a partial Solr. As I said, at that time it wasn't available. Now I checked, it has all the features I need and even more. So I will, because it is actually pretty easy, I will probably migrate, but I have to test first to see if it will behave the same or better way. Now the plan is to introduce, and this has been a plan for a long time, but the issue is that we didn't have any time. So to do a third index with subtitles, so people can actually do a full text search on subtitles, and it returns them the time on the recording of different recordings, the time so they can find the term which they used inside the video. And also the plan is to optimize Solr search with fuzzy search, but there is a problem because Slovenian is such a small language. yeah, I mean,
you have to do it on your own.
Yeah, that's the problem. So yeah, this is how the web service Solr actually is used. It just plugs into a Solr and pulls out the response docs. If you give it a query and returns the response to this object. The queries we use are, it has the, we use the, it has a search of query optimization, but it didn't work in our case because it doesn't support all the features you need, so we just didn't input the Solr query in it. So this is how it behaves. So you can see about 3,000 requests, and it works under 40 milliseconds. So after we finished that, we added some other features. This is a subtitle editor, because we got some, this is for, basically for hearing impaired people. it's only Slovenian subtitles for now, but it really helps people with this. We also have an option with for the blind, where it describes what is happening on the video, but that's really on a small scale because it takes a lot of time, just for some. And we also introduced the geotag option, so they can every part of the video can be basically geotagged. So when somebody searches for a location, it returns all the videos that have that location tagged inside of it. Now these are, I said already, geoblocking for live is done on the GetAnswer. Also, we write files that geoblock the bot from the same interface. I've done a little project where I do geoblocking of progressive download with the answer. It's a separate project. Basically, it gets the request, sees if the file is geoblocked, and returns it or not. But I had to bypass the answer with for this large files, because the serving large files through the answer is suboptimal, to say the least. Also, we are now doing the WASA. We are going to take the full control of WASA, connect with it, and we did also a small project. People really like it. It's basically back in time radio, so when you hear somebody say something funny on the radio, you can go back, cut it, and share it on Facebook or Twitter or whatever. And people really, people really like it. So what we use, as I said, the answer one, it is impossible currently to migrate it. Because we don't have the funds. Template food, MySQL, Dancer plugin database, Solr, web service Solr, and Dancer plugin out extensible. I did this talk on Yabse Sofia, and somebody wrote to me that there should be a live presentation. So I'm gonna try to. So this is the web page, this is the archive part, and this is the autocomplete. So you see, it's pretty fast for that amount of data. So I was fast as usual. Any questions?